Something is highly unusual at a volcano in the United States' largest national park. What you are looking at are the remains of the massive stratovolcano in question, which is known as Mount Drum. Located in Alaska, it towers above the surrounding landscape to an impressive height of 12,011 feet or 3,661 meters above sea level. Highly glacially eroded, Mount Drum by all means is thought to be extinct, having not erupted in approximately 250,000 years. And yet, something strange occurs at this volcano which challenges our traditional notion of a volcano being extinct. Take a look, for example, at all of these dead trees and vegetation which were not caused by earthquakes, humans, or insects. Instead, it was a separate natural hazard which also killed off a group of songbirds which came to temporarily rest. What I am referring to are excessive amounts of carbon dioxide at select low points on the ground and in the soil, which reached such high levels that they killed off both plants and animals. This carbon dioxide is being released by a series of vents, some of which are not immediately obvious on Mount Drum slopes between 11.5 and 19 miles west of its summit. The carbon dioxide reached such a high pressure that at several vents it caused particles of rock and dirt to become pulverized, mixing with water to form a slurry of mud, which subsequently erupted onto the surface. These mud volcanoes do not erupt lava but instead mud, as their name implies, with one specific vent having grown to 1.2 miles wide and 165 feet tall. Not only do these vents regularly emit approximately 20 tons of carbon dioxide along with lesser amounts of other gases every day, but the nature of the helium which is released indicates a largely magmatic origin. In contrast, only some of the carbon dioxide is magmatic, with the rest resulting from the decomposition by extreme heat of a thick layer of limestone. How much heat, you might ask? Greater than 750 degrees Celsius. In other words, there is some form of an active magma chamber, perhaps cooling, perhaps fairly new, somewhere in the vicinity underneath these three mud volcanoes. This magma likely has an andesitic composition and has been creating mud volcanism on the surface for at least the last 75 years, if not longer. With this taken into account, can we truly consider Mount Drum as extinct? In my opinion, no we cannot, and it would be best to reclassify Mount Drum as merely dormant with a low but non-zero possibility of one day erupting again. However, it could also represent a completely separate magmatic intrusion associated with the slowly westward trending motion of volcanism within Wrangell St. Elias National Park, meaning this could one day be the site of the region's next brand new volcano. Whichever is the case, magma is definitely present somewhere in the crust, and I might have an idea where exactly it is. By overlaying every single earthquake to strike in a 1,550 square mile rectangle in the last 50 years, a notable cluster of earthquakes pops up. While Mount Drum has essentially produced zero earthquakes, a cluster of more than 700 earthquakes has struck in a 16 square mile region which almost perfectly underlies all three mud volcanoes. These earthquakes largely occurred at between 15 and 18 kilometers or 9.3 to 11.2 miles depth, and in my opinion, this is where the magma chamber likely is. Altogether, these three mud volcanoes, which are still quite fairly active, have recently covered 6.75 square miles in a layer of mud. While not even remotely the size of Azerbaijan's hydrocarbon-related mud volcanoes, which can get up to 6.2 miles wide and 2,300 feet tall, they are still quite an impressive size. And if you live near Silver Springs, Alaska, if you look across the Copper River, you might see a patch of muddy ground that represents where mud from the lower Kolwezi mud volcano travels nearly 5 miles to reach that point and enter the Copper River. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube member, MindZ, for supporting this channel.